Let us look at the classroom. The Google Classroom is an application which we can use it for your virtual classroom. The Google Classroom, download it from the App Store, iOS or Android App Store. You can get a Google Classroom which will look like this. You can just get into that one. So when you go to the Google Classroom, you can see a three line at the top left hand corner and your Gmail at the right top hand corner. If you just press on the three lines, which opens your menu bar where you can see the classes. Just press on classes, it will give you the main page, or you can see a list of classes. So whichever the class you press on, it will press on to the particular, take you to the particular class pages. For example, if I press on the second one, that is biology one, if I press on this, it will just take you to the biology classroom. So for the creation of the classroom, you can just press on the plus icon which is present in the top left hand corner in the Androids, where in case of iOS it is in the lower portion in case of the bottom of the right hand corner. Just press on that. If you press on that, you can see the join classes and create classes. You can just press on the create classes. It will take you the dialog box whether you wanted to use the privacy security or what. You can just check that box and press continue. Gives you a list. Just press on, just type your class. Let me write a demo class here. You can just press on create. Now it will create your classroom. So now our class is created, SVG Online Demo Class. So this is how it looks like in case of the page when it is open. It shows a stream, classwork and people. So I'll just go back to the menu bar. Now we can see the menu bar, we have our classroom. It shows a zero student because no students yet entered into the classes. So when you open that classroom, you can just see a settings icon on your top right handed corner. Just press on the settings icon. So dialog box opens and you can just check it out. General class code is given. So just keep holding the class code. It will get copied, or you may get a copy option. Just copy that class code and share that class code with your student so that students can join into your classes. So there's a one option, how can you join your students your class by using the class code. The students can join the class by using the class code, or else we can just add the students if we know their email ID by inviting them. For that you can just go to the people. If you press on people, you can make out teachers and students. So you can just press teachers, can add teachers email ID, or if you press students, just type on the email ID and send the invitation to the students, and they have to accept that invitation. If they accept the invitation, they will be entered into your classrooms. This is how you can enroll the students into your classroom. Next we'll move on to the main sharing button. We have stream and classroom, two more options. So what do you mean by stream? Stream is nothing but whatever the informations you have provided to the students in terms of assignment, in terms of questions, in terms of materials, in terms of notes, anything that you are providing them, anything that you have given, any measures or any of the things you have given, all those things will be displayed in the this one. It is acts as a notice board. So now if you move on to the classroom, now we can make out the three lines at the top left hand corner. If you press that, it will take you to the list of the main menu, or if you press the plus button at the lower portion, it just gives you different things such as assignment, questions, materials, repost and topic. Topic is the one, it could be a chapter name or it could be the subordinate name which you are using, or subtopic name which you are using in the chapter. So where assignment will provide you, you can give some assignment on them to them so that they can answer the assignment and repost them back to your in your classes. I'll create one assignment here, such as name. Sorry, instead of that, characteristics. Family Malvasia. Can it's a question. The same time you can give the number of points to be allotted for the particular assignment. It's maximum number of points to be allotted. It may be a 10 or 20 or 25, whichever the marks you are allotting. Next, give a due date. It could be on whichever the date you wanted to want them to be submit their assignment to you. So the due date and the time also you can give, such as 11:59, or such as I will write put 11 a.m. Okay, so now the 3rd June 11 a.m. within that they have to submit the assignment. If they haven't submit the assignment, it shows handed in late. It means the student has submitted the assignment lately. So here you can write the topic, whichever the topic comes, the question comes in that particular topic. For example, I will write morphology of flower and save. So you can share the images or any other informations along with this. Instead of along with the question, you can share the other things, such as you can just take a pic, or you can just share the things what you have in case of your gallery. So I'm not going to share anything here. If you want, you can share over there. So you can just press this arrow button, so which will create the question in your classroom. Once it created the question in your classroom, it will directly redirect back to your classroom, and in the classroom it shows what is the question. The same way in stream it shows the question is given at a particular date. All the question, assignments, materials, everything will be showed up on the stream button. So here once you click it on, it indicates handed in and assigned. 0 handed in, 0 assigned, it is mentioned here because I do not have any students in here. So that is why it is showed 0 assigned. If you have 30 students, then it shows 30 assigned. So how many students will hand over the assignment, and the number would be showed at that particular this one. So I will just take you to one of the assignments so that you can make out how it looks like. So I'll just take you to a question that I have given in the few days back. Just go to the different. So this is how it looks like. You can make out hormonal action, the topic hormonal action. If you are creating questions, all those things will come here. Under the genetics, the questions which is given will be appear here. The same way in the evolution and the pedigree analysis. So in case of, I just show one of the assignment is provided to them, such as this one. So here 24 assigned and 11 marked. So total 35 students are present in this class. So we have 11 students already marked, and 24 students have not submitted their assignments. So those who have submitted their assignment will appear first. Then once you marked them and returned them, those things will appear at the end as marked. So if I take this assignment, so here in assignment I have edited the assignment. So this is the image that student have submitted. So once a student have submitted the assignment, I can edit those assignment by just editing option, the pencil what we have here, we can use that one for the editing option. And these assignments edited, let me just give you some options here, I'll just check it out for the others. So now you can make out, it's an eraser, you have a pen, you have the marker, you can also type. So you can just use the pen, by clicking on the pen it will give you the different options, colors, you can, the colors you can opt the thickness of the pen, and you can just mark whichever or wherever you wanted to mark it. So once you mark it, you can just go to the save. Once you save it, everything would be saved and returned back. I'm not going to save it because it's already saved. So return back as the other image what is given, such as I'll just show up these images. This is edited image where we can mark, we can type, we can insert the text by using the text icon which is present in the edited option, the one what we have it later. So you can just mark it back. Once you mark it back, it can mark the number, how much number you have wanted to provide them, probably how much number you wanted to give. You can just give a mark, and once you marked it, it will provide you, ask you as an return, whether you want to return it to the students or not. If you want to return it to students, you can just press return, it will return back to the students. So you can just press return, so the students will intimate that their material been corrected and returned back. So it's been returned. Once it return, it will be mentioned in returned column, so where the others are not handed in their assignments. So this is one thing. The same way we can also give the questions. So this is a question option, the same way you can just try to type the questions, the points, due date, topic, whether you wanted to give us a short answer or a multiple answer. If you want to give a multiple answer, you can just press option, just as you can go on the options, as you type on, it go to the next point, next option, next multiple choice when you enter the point, enter button. Or if you are asking the short answers, it will ask you to write the answers, student can edit the answer, whether you wanted to student edit the answers, you can keep that button on, or if you don't want, you cannot keep the button on, you can just switch it off. Our students can reply to each other, you can just keep that off so that students cannot reply to each other the answers, so you can just submit it. So the same way we can go for the short answers and also for the multiple choices what we have. You can just show a multiple choice questions which I've already given for them and they have handed in some of the questions. So as you have typing, it will just answer the questions. Like I will just write A, B, C, D. So you can just, you can, it will just give you the multiple choices option, that is answer A, answer B, answer C and answer D, and you can just post it so that they will get the question. So I've already given up on questions, you can just go through that. I will just, so this is one of the question, multiple choice questions what I have given to them. Industrial Malaysianism is an example, each question carries 4 marks. So here mentioned we have 26 assigned and 9 handed in. So we have 9 students handed or returned their questions by the answer, where the remaining students are not returned at. So I'll just correct the questions. One of the questions over here, we just mentioned the question here. Once you click on the questions, it will show the answer what is given. So the right options what they have selected, it will show here. If it is right, you can just mark it. Like if it is right, you can just give 4. It means it is understood that it is right. If you are given 0, it understood that it is not right, it is wrong. In the case of multiple choice answers. So then slowly, and then next, you can just return the question or assignment back to the student, just pressing return option. So it would be returned now. Once it return, you can see here 8 is handed in, 26 is assigned, where 1 is marked. So now I have already marked 1, and that mark thing has come at the lowest part. It will be present here. So those who are handed in, they will be present at this particular part, that is in the topmost portions. So the same way you can provide the material, you can just share a material by going for the share option. I'll just go back, discard, press plus icon, you can just go to the material option, you can just type the title of the material, and you can share the material which you wanted to share in the form of PDF or in the form of picture. Or also you can share a link, or you also share the link through your URL address can also be shared directly through the websites which you are working in. You can just go for that one. Okay, I have just mechanism of hormone action. I wanted to share this one with that classroom. I just go to the share button and I just go to the classroom. In the classroom page, you can just click on create material and type the question or type the subject of the material, then just press share button, and now it's already shared in my classroom. You can just go back, you can just check it out. In hormone action, it is already shared. As I have not given the topic, so you can just give the topic there. You can also go and edit it going there, but you can just a hormone action as a editing as a topic, save it, and once you save that one, by after giving the topic, it will show you under your hormonal action. Click on the material, you show the link. So once you press on this link, it will take you to the respective website or the YouTube page. So it's a very simple applications which will be very useful for the teachers and also students to share their knowledge and the questions or the queries. we can also do some settings such as notification settings. You can keep an email notification, you can turn it on or turn off. You can also get a comment. All these notifications, all these settings are automatically turned on. If you want, turn it off or let it be keeping like that. It'll help you. You'll get a notification in your email or your cell phone. So this is about the Google Classroom. Hope you have understood and came to know about the Google Classroom. Thank you very much for listening and watching the video.